Welcome to Space News from the Electric Universe, brought to you by the Thunderbolts Project at thunderbolts.info. A new scientific discovery provides stunning confirmation of a foundational tenet of the electric universe. A team of scientists have discovered a vast radio-emitting filament of plasma, which stretches across 10 million light years, connecting two clusters of galaxies called Abell 0399 and 0401. The filament, which a scientist discovered using a low-frequency radio telescope called LOFAR, also marks the first time scientists have found a magnetic field connecting two galactic clusters. The radio emission the filament emits is synchrotron radiation, which the Electric Universe theory proposes is produced by spiraling electrons along an intergalactic Birkeland current. As stated by astronomer Matteo Murgia, we typically observe this emission mechanism in action in individual galaxies, and even in galaxy clusters. But never before has a radio emission been observed connecting two of these systems. A ScienceAlert.com report on the discovery states, "The electrons are covering way more distance than is expected, which means there has to be another element at play." In other words, as proponents of the electric universe and plasma cosmology have been arguing for decades, and as demonstrated through decades of laboratory experiments, everything the astronomers are observing, the structure of the filament itself, its colossal magnetic field, and its emission of synchrotron radiation mean one thing. Across an unimaginable cosmic distance, electric currents connect the two galactic clusters. However, since electric currents have never been part of astrophysical theory, to try to explain the synchrotron radiation emission, the team has proposed that shock waves from the galaxies merging, quote, re-accelerated high-speed electrons, producing the detected emissions. But as noted in the Science Alert report, we don't know where the pre-existing relativistic electrons came from. Their velocity implies an energetic origin that could have ejected them at speed, such as supernovae. Collisions, explosions, shock waves, and other turbulent chaotic processes. The stunning reality is that these are the only processes available to astrophysicists to try to explain the stupendous electromagnetic phenomena that are now undeniable throughout the cosmos. But it's equally undeniable that gravity-centric cosmology did not predict these phenomena, nor can it explain them through the gravitational toolkit. We've repeatedly emphasized the importance of astrophysicists' detection of pervasive, tremendous magnetic fields at all scales in the universe. The ultimate credibility of any scientific theory is its ability to make successful predictions. We again note for your consideration the 1999 NASA piece, which stated on the question, "Do magnetic fields exist in space?" On the cosmological scale, there is no data to suggest that magnetic fields are present. They certainly are not important in the dynamics of the universe for any reasonable range of field strengths consistent with present observational constraints. Since mainstream cosmology dismissed cosmic magnetic fields as, quote, not important, it should not be surprising that gravitational theory has failed completely to either predict or explain countless space discoveries. At the galactic scale, a commonly held belief among astrophysicists is that supernova explosions over eons of time are responsible for the tremendous magnetic fields of many galaxies. But this belief requires that the magnetic fields be chaotic. But what astrophysicists have actually discovered is an astonishing order to the magnetic fields. As noted in a phys.org report from last year, galactic magnetic fields are formed through numerous stellar explosions, the effects of which last for hundreds of millions of years. The energy bursts of all supernovas put together produce a galaxy's magnetic fields. Due to the fact that stellar explosions are chaotic processes, scientists had not expected them to generate a magnetic field with an orderly structure on a large scale. But this is exactly what they have now proved to be the case in several galaxies. The underlying mechanisms have not yet been fully understood. The association of magnetic fields with cosmic filaments is now acknowledged in mainstream astrophysics. On a smaller scale, in 2018, scientists reported the first ever measurement of the, quote, magnetic bridge linking the Milky Way's two nearest galaxies. Known as the Magellanic Bridge, the filament stretches for approximately 75,000 light years, connecting the large and small Magellanic clouds. One of the researchers stated, "Not only are entire galaxies magnetic, but the faint, delicate threads joining galaxies are magnetic too. Everywhere we look in the sky, we find magnetism." The lead author of the study stated, "In general, we don't know how such vast magnetic fields are generated, nor how these large-scale magnetic fields affect galaxy formation and evolution. Understanding the role that magnetic fields play in the evolution of galaxies and their environment is a fundamental question in astronomy that remains to be answered. Perhaps this is because astrophysicists have never allowed the one mechanism, an electric current, known to produce and maintain a well-ordered magnetic field. Plasma cosmology has proposed for many decades that cosmic-scale electric currents play a fundamental role in the formation and evolution of stars and galaxies. It is not a coincidence that the Herschel Space Telescope has imaged stars forming along filaments of remarkably constant width, a hallmark of electrical discharge, yet an impossible gravitational process. Likewise, astrophysicists have believed for many years that galaxies are also strung along networks of filaments, though they imagine that the filaments are composed of hypothetical dark matter. But as we've outlined many times on this series, the electromagnetic nature of galaxies is the most promising path for eliminating the perceived need for dark matter. It was many decades ago that plasma scientists began reproducing the evolution and form of galaxies through simple experiments with electrical discharge. Perhaps most noteworthy was the experiments of Dr. Anthony Peratt of Los Alamos Laboratories, who recreated barred spiral galaxies in simulations with interacting twin current filaments. More recently, retired professor of electrical engineering Dr. Donald Scott published a scientific paper, Birkeland Currents in Dark Matter, which demonstrates that the velocity of a Birkeland current compares remarkably well to anomalous stellar velocity profiles, a long-standing mystery which astrophysicists believe demands the existence of dark matter. Again, the most meaningful test of any theory's credibility is its predictive record. We note that as far back as 1992, Dr. Peratt discussed the evidence for, quote, supercluster-scale electric currents in his textbook, Physics of the Plasma Universe. In the chapter entitled Currents in the Intergalactic Medium, Peratt writes, "One of the most compelling pieces of evidence for the existence of supercluster-sized currents comes from the discovery of faint supercluster-scale radio emissions at 326 MHz between the Coma cluster of galaxies and the Abell 167 cluster." Peratt then writes on the, quote, "radiation's synchrotron origins." In Peratt's view, these intergalactic currents are spiraling Birkeland currents, which will accelerate charged particles in circles, that is, orthogonal to the current's direction, which must then generate synchrotron radiation. Contrary to the ad hoc theory astrophysicists have offered, no shock waves from explosions are required. One thing is certain. The discovery of such a vast plasma bridge connecting galactic clusters affirms at least one prediction. There are no islands in our electric universe.